class, this is Mrs. Gallegos, and today we are going to have a tutorial on how to write formulas for ionic compounds using the crisscross method. This information can be found in Chapter 8, Section 2 of your textbook. The tutorial will follow the following outline. First, we will determine the charge of ions. Then, we will use the crisscross method to write the formula of an ionic compound, and then we'll practice. Determining the charge of ions. The first ions that we will need to determine the charge of are ions formed out of the elements. Remember, we learned that the charges of the elements follow a periodic pattern. All of the alkali metals and hydrogen form plus one ions. All of the alkaline earth metals, beryllium on down, form plus two ions. The transition metals, there is no pattern, and so we must look those up in our book. Boron and its column form plus three ions. Carbon and its column, generally you won't find them in an ionic compound, but if you do, they can form plus four or minus four ions. Nitrogen and its column or group form minus three ions. Oxygen and its family, minus two ions. And last but not least, the halogens form the minus one ions. Remember, all of our non-metals form negative ions, and all of our metals form positive ions. The noble gases don't form ions at all. Again, transition metals, we need to look them up on page 222 of your book. Examples would be silver is a plus one ion, zinc is a two plus ion, and copper can be either plus one or two plus ion. And the copper one ion, or the plus one ion, is called copper one after its charge. Polyatomic ions, you need to memorize six of them, and you know what they are. They're the ions in bold on your ion sheet that you glued into your interactive notebook. Or you can look up any other ions that are unfamiliar on page 224 in your book. And when we look at a polyatomic ion, it has both a formula, like NO3, and it has a charge, minus. And this would be the nitrate ion. The hydroxide ion, OH, is its formula, and then minus 1 is its charge. Sulfate, SO4, is its formula, and 2 minus is its charge. Topic 2, crisscross method. A typical problem would be, write the formula of an ionic compound made out of magnesium and oxygen ions. So step 1, write the charge of both ions using the periodic table or polyatomic ion sheet. Magnesium, if I look it up in my periodic table, is in the second column with the alkaline earth metals, and it will form 2 plus ions. Oxygen is in the non-metal side of the periodic table in the column right before the halogens, and those elements form 2 minus ions. Then, if I can, I reduce the charges with the lowest common denominator. So magnesium and oxygen can both be divided by 2, and so now my charges are going to be plus 1 and minus 1. Next, I'm going to actually do the crisscross. So the charge on the cation is going to become the subscript on the anion. The charge on the anion becomes the subscript of the cation. Crisscross. 4. Subscripts of 1 are not written in the final formula, so my final formula will simply be MgO. The substance is called magnesium oxide. Practice. Problem 1. What is the formula for an ionic compound made of calcium and chlorine? Step 1. Write the charge of both ions using the periodic table or polyatomic ion sheet. If I look up calcium, I find it is an alkaline earth metal and it will have a 2 plus charge. If I look up chlorine, it's a halogen and it will have a minus 1 charge. Step 2. Reduce the charges with the lowest common denominator. There is no common denominator for 2 and minus 1, so they will not reduce anymore, so I'll leave them as is. Next, I crisscross. The oxidation number of my anion becomes the subscript of my cation, and the charge of my cation becomes the subscript of my anion, and my formula will be Ca1Cl2. And as you know, I don't need to write the subscripts, so the final formula is CaCl2, calcium chloride. Problem number two. What is the formula for an ionic compound made out of potassium and NO3, the polyatomic ion named nitrate? So first, I write the charge of both ions using the periodic table or the polyatomic ion sheet. I discover that potassium is an alkaline metal and has a +1 charge. And when I look up where I have memorized NO3, I know it has a -1 charge. I reduce the charges with the lowest common denominator. These are already reduced, 1 and 1. Then I crisscross. The charge on the anion, this polyatomic ion, now becomes the subscript for my cation, and the charge for my cation becomes the subscript for my anion. I will now have K1, NO3, 1. However, since they're both 1, I don't need to write the subscript of 1, so my formula will be KNO3. Problem number 3. What is the formula for an ionic compound made out of aluminum and nitrate? First, I write the charge of both ions using the periodic table or polyatomic ion sheet. Aluminum is in the third column of the periodic table, and it has a 3+ charge. NO3 nitrate I've memorized or I've looked up on my polyatomic ion sheet and discovered that it has a minus charge. I crisscross, but first I reduce the charges with the lowest common denominator. These are already reduced. Then I crisscross. So my formula will be Al1NO3 3. I don't need to write subscripts of 1, so my formula will now be AlNO3 3. Well, that's kind of a problem because I don't want to communicate that I have 33 oxygens. I want to communicate that I have 3 NO3s. So the way we solve this problem is by putting in parentheses. So when I'm using polyatomic ions and I have more than one of them, because the subscript is greater than 1, I will put parentheses around the polyatomic ion. So I hope this tutorial was helpful.